Okay, we're joined now by our second guest of the day in the studio, and it's Henrietta Adu of the Burwash Pharmacy. Welcome to you, Henrietta. It's lovely to have you on the show. So we're here to talk about what's going on, 2016, colds, flus, viruses. I mean, many people have it. I've actually had one recently as well. Felt like the flu. What's going around at the moment?
Yes, there are many different viruses going around. It's important to differentiate between the cold and the actual flu. Flu is a lot more serious, and there are three viruses that can cause that. And the GPs are trying to get all the elderly, people who are expectant, people who are on immunosuppressant, to get the flu vaccine. And really, that's one of the best ways that you can avoid the flu. Other ways you can do it is making sure that you keep yourself warm. We've had a sudden change in temperature, you know, and it's only now we've just had a sudden dip in the temperature, and you lose a lot of heat for your head, and basically when you start to shiver, it reduces your immune response, and it then makes you more likely to feel ill and get the cold. And also avoiding crowded areas, because then close proximity with people, more likely to get the germs as well. And people having heating on very high, the central heating, that can kind of dry the nasal passages and make you also more prone to get flus, because it reduces your immune system.
I didn't know, actually, being that too warm. Yeah, no, carry on.
Yes. Yeah, and also the other thing is hygiene, washing your hands and avoiding the spread of germs. And it's just that if you do have the germs and then you touch your nose, your eyes, that way it gets spread. So there are many ways you can, you know, you can help yourself without taking medication. Echinacea is one medication that you can get from the pharmacy as well. That is a natural medication done by the native Indians, and that boosts your immune system.
So what's that? How's that made?
It's a native plant material that now it's made into a capsule that you can buy, and that boosts your immune system. But taking that for longer periods than 6 weeks can often not be a very good idea. Yeah, so
you mentioned before the flu jab. I mean, people may not be aware that you can do that, that they're eligible. Is anyone eligible to do that? Is that a free jab?
It's free for certain criteria of people. Free. People over 60, people under 16, people with chronic conditions such as asthma, immune systems, people who've got HIV. So all those categories of people can get it free, and the GPs often write to them and phone them and to get them through. They've now actually opened it up, so those people who normally get it free can also go to a pharmacy and get it free from a pharmacy. Before, people who weren't eligible to get it free used to go and pay for it privately. But now anyone, whether you pay or not, can also get it from a pharmacy. And that opens up, makes it easier to get appointments, because with pharmacy you can often walk in and get it done.
Do you find that this time of year, when the temperatures dramatically change, and we have seen a dramatic change. I mean, I think today and Wednesday is supposed to be -2 degrees, that's below freezing. Do you find that this is the busiest time at your pharmacy, where people are coming in ill with colds and flus?
I have seen a big increase, actually, with people, you know, having the dribbles, and yes.
Yeah, yes, I've seen one of them. Well, what are the best remedies then? Can you name a few?
The best remedies is to make sure that you take something that's going to dry up your sinuses. So the active ingredient, I won't name a specific product, because a whole range of products will contain that pseudoephedrine that dries up the secretions. Then obviously you want to treat the pain to get your temperature down, and getting any product that contains ibuprofen, I would go for that in preference over paracetamol, because that also it's an anti-inflammatory as well as reducing your temperature, so it will help with all those aches and pains.
Thank
those
you very much.
Active ingredients.
Thank you, Henrietta. Some good advice there. It's time now for a very quick break now, but join us back when we're talking to Henrietta Adu again from the Burwash Pharmacy. See you soon. Welcome back to Latest TV's a big new show. Coming up, we'll have your weather forecast, but first, and we're still joined by our resident health expert, it's Henrietta Adu of the Burwash Pharmacy. And Henrietta, before the break, we were talking about the best remedies, etc. Tell me about lemsip, honey, lemon, that whole mix. Is that something that actually does work, or is that something that's just flies around as a myth?
You have this information database called the Cochrane, and when I looked at that, just out of interest to see, And they, with all the research they've done, they found that vitamins, which is vitamin C, which you would get in Lemsip, and extra fluid, hasn't been shown to reduce the incidence of colds and flus. But what I would say from the experiences that we've had, that it helps people rest, having that hot drink, having that vitamin C, helps people rest, have a good night's sleep, and in so as your body's resting, it helps you fight and combat the flu. So it's a debatable one. Evidence would say it doesn't, but practical knowledge and what people come back with the feedback that it does.
That's right, because I would have thought vitamin C, drink lots of vitamin C. My mum would tell me, drink lots of water, lots of vitamin C, you'll avoid getting ill or you'll recover quicker. On that topic, what are the different ways that you can recover quicker?
The best way to recover quick is to make sure you rest really, so your body can, you know, build up its immune system, and make sure that you do things like the painkillers, as we talked about, ibuprofen to help with the pain relief.
Is that because that's anti-inflammatory, isn't it? Is that right?
It's an anti-inflammatory. Okay. So an anti-inflammatory does two things: help you with pain relief, and it helps reduce all the muscle aches and pains that you get with the flu. So that's, you know, the key thing that you can do is rest and do that. And really, I would always advocate the hot drinks, the Lemsip. They also contain things like pseudoephedrine, which help dry up secretions, so that also helps. And they sometimes contain some antihistamines, and they help you have a good night's sleep. So,
Henrietta, what about exercise and perspiring and that sort of thing? Does that help you recover faster?
We would say stay away from strenuous exercise and just give that a break, so your body can recover.
How did you actually get into being a pharmacist? What was your journey into this profession?
I really enjoyed chemistry at school and wanted to do something that was applied chemistry, not work in a lab. And pharmacy kind of fitted all the boxes. It involves a lot of chemistry, and it's an applied thing, so it's a professional qualification, so it's 4 years at university, then 1 year working under supervision. So my journey before I became a community pharmacist and before I opened my own business at Burwash Pharmacy was a hospital pharmacist, where you gained a lot of speciality and you worked with close contacts with doctors and actually saw the clinical pharmacy. And then after that I moved into primary care, which was looking at how doctors prescribe and monitoring that. And then after that, I think there have been so many recent changes to how the community pharmacy operates, and in all the services they can provide the general public, that, you know, I moved into that. So there's a whole variety of things. We do the flu vaccination. We can provide customers with emergency hormonal contraception. We can provide stop smoking services, and the list goes on. And I'm currently undertaking a course where I can also become an independent prescriber. So within the pharmacy, you also prescribe for set conditions like respiratory conditions, evaluate how people use their inhalers, and monitor them.
Is that one of the perks of the job, is actually to help people, isn't
it? Yes, that is.
Is that part of why you do it? I mean, explain to me why, what kind of satisfaction you get from helping others. Recover from the flu and the cold.
And I think also because I work in a small community up in the Hangleton, you actually get to know your customers, so you can follow on, you know, they come with you and maybe there's a test or an examination that they're doing 2 months down the line, and they start a course of treatment, and then three, 4 months down the line, you still get to see them, and it's a new person, they've recovered, they've, you know, got over that hill.
That sounds really lovely, especially the local community aspect, like you mentioned. Moving on, what's the oddest inquiry you've ever had? If there have been a few, you can mention a few.
I'm just thinking now, the oddest inquiry. We once had someone who wanted to get some litmus paper. Litmus paper is what you use to check for acidity and alkalinity, and that's because they worked in a university and they couldn't get it there for their small experiments they were doing, so they came to me for that. So that was one of the oddest ones, because it was nothing very sort of clinical.
Oh, that's quite odd. Do you get a lot of young children coming in at the moment with colds and flus, or is it mainly elderly people?
It's a mixture of both, the elderly and the young, I'd say, throughout the spectrum,
I mean, what's the best thing for young babies and toddlers to have then? Of course, they've got to have something more mild, don't they? Is it the same with elderly people?
Well, with young toddlers, I would always recommend things like a humidifier, make sure their room is kept moist, because as I mentioned before, the dry heat from central heating, keep them moist. And basically, things like the eucalyptus oil, where the natural, more natural products that they can have. And also things like saline douches, because that, I don't know whether you know what I mean by saline douche.
I don't. Can you explain, please?
Sure. It's a spray that you kind of spray up your nasal passage, and it washes and rinses out the germs and the bacteria in your nasal passage, and that kind of helps with the inflammation and helps improve the cold symptom. So with young kids, that's often quite good, because often with them, they can't use the decongestants that adults can use.
And being a pharmacist yourself, it may seem like a silly question, but do you find that you're able to keep yourself quite immune to these things more than the average
person? I try.
Really?
I try. Make sure I get my flu vaccine done, so that helps.
Oh, well, it's been lovely to speak to you. I won't try drinking more vitamin C and water. I think that's not what you're trying to say. But, of course, it's been interesting to talk to you about these myths and things like that. But thank you very much for all the remedies and tips that you've given us today. That's Henrietta Adu from the Burwash Pharmacy.